Church, amen.
Amen.
It's good to be back in the house of the Lord this evening to worship Him in spirit and in truth. I enjoyed myself this morning for Father's Day.
All right.
My family came with me.
Yes.
I guess that was good. Just what I wanted good for them to be here this morning. And I enjoyed Brother Melvin's little sermon.
Yes.
All right. I thought I let it know that.
Yeah.
Everybody keeps saying he keeps jump starting like he's gonna preach.
Yeah.
One of these days we're gonna be able to sit him down.
Yeah.
You know, I was thinking about that. I was thinking about that. You know, I've been knowing Melvin close to 50 years.
Yeah. All right, all right.
Billy Johnson. Yeah. Billy Joe Mason. I've been knowing these people a long time,
right. Yeah. Amen.
And so I'm pretty used to them, you know.
Yeah.
So I love being here.
All right.
I might as well say that.
Amen.
Because the average actor ran me off a long time ago. I'm not going to let him run me off.
Right.
So I thought I'd stay.
Yeah.
All right.
But today I want to talk about an unusual subject. It's about Cornelius.
Yes, sir.
I mean, Cornelius, when I think about him, you know, how hard it must have been for him being a Gentile.
Yes, sir.
Because, you know, the Romans didn't have any love for Christians.
That's right.
They were the one who crucified Christ on the cross.
Right.
And he was of that same race.
Yes.
He was a centurion. He was a Roman officer. And it's strange the affection that he had for God. The Bible said there was a certain man in Caesarea called Cornelius, a centurion, a man called the Italian man, a devout man, extremely religious man, and one that feared God with all his heart, and gave much alms to the people, and prayed to God always. He saw in a vision, evidently about the ninth hour of the day, an angel of God coming in to him and saying unto him, Cornelius. And when he looked on him, he was afraid.
Yes.
And said, what is it, Lord? And he said unto him, thy prayer and thy alms are come up for a memorial before God.
All right.
Cornelius was an extremely religious man. A man that prayed to God always and gave on to the people. He don't sound like a Roman soldier, do it. This was a good man. But Cornelius had a problem. He was also an outsider.
Yes, sir.
You see, because only the Jews was acceptable unto God. He was an outsider. But he had studied the word of God.
Yes, sir.
He learned to fear God. It's not many of us today to fear God. But Cornelius feared him. And he didn't even have a relationship with God. Because he was not a Jew. David, come on down and get the book.
Amen.
Just come on down. You shouldn't have showed up.
Yeah.
You didn't want to do nothing. You should have stayed where you were.
Amen.
You come on down. And but you know, Jesus had said in Matthew 7, ask, and it shall be given you.
That's right.
Seek, and you shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. anyone that asketh receive it.
That's right.
And he that seeketh find it. Uh-huh. And to him that knocketh, it shall be open.
Yes, sir.
You know, Cornelius apparently had read about this.
That's right.
But he had no desire to become a Jew. Because if he would have come a Jew, he had to be circumcised.
That's right.
He would have to keep the Sabbath.
Yes, sir.
And he would have had to change his diet.
Yes, sir.
Come on. Because Jews only had a certain diet.
That's right.
But this was a Roman soldier. He had 100 men under his control.
Yes, sir.
He was an officer in the Roman army. And I know this had to be hard for him. He couldn't have been circumcised because he was a Roman.
Yes, sir.
But he wanted a relationship with God.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah.
The Bible says that he prayed constantly to God.
Right. Yes, sir.
Some of us don't do that.
No.
You know, this man had every qualification to be a child of God,
that's right.
But he was not a child of God because he was a Roman. But you know, God had made a promise to Abraham a long time ago, didn't he? Telling him that all the nations of the earth will be blessed through thy seed. But they never had got around to the Gentiles yet.
Yes, sir.
There was many who had been baptized into the body of Christ, but they was all Jews.
That's right.
It was not a Gentile in the house. And you know, that Ethiopian eunuch, he was just not Ethiopian, he was a proselyte Jew. So he don't care. Is that right? And I remember reading in Luke 16.
Yes, sir.
When the rich man was talking to Abraham. And you know, God told him. Abraham told him about he wanted somebody to go back and tell his brethren. But he said, they got Moses and the prophets.
That's right.
Let them hear them.
That's it,
you know, God have a purpose for preachers.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Right. You remember in Acts 9 when Paul was on his way to Damascus, when God blinded out his eyes on Damascus Highway.
That's right.
And Paul couldn't see.
Yes,
and God recommended him to go to a man named Ananias.
That's right, preacher.
And he will tell you what I want you to do.
That's it.
Now all of these voices, these angels of God recommending people, like the angels recommended Philip to go to the eunuch, right?
Right.
Okay, now the angel is directing Paul to Ananias.
Amen.
Well, what is this about?
Come on.
God has preachers that he put on this earth.
That's right.
And you got to hear the preacher.
Yes.
Is that right? Right? Because Romans 10, David.
Amen.
Romans 10 and I think around about use 13 and 14.
Yeah. Read. For whosoever
call on the name of the Lord
shall be saved.
How then?
Shall they call on them?
In whom they have not believed.
And how shall they believe in him?
How can they believe in him?
Of whom they have not heard.
Of whom they have not heard.
And how shall they hear?
And how can they hear?
Without a preacher.
All right, sir.
God He could have told Cornelius, this is how you save yourself. But God didn't do that, did he? He could have told him. The angels of God, they know what salvation is.
Right.
They come down from heaven and they already know what salvation is.
Uh-huh.
Is that right?
Right?
But Cornelius was a man that was after God's own heart.
That's right.
You know, we don't talk much about Cornelius, but he's really our father. He's the father of the Gentiles.
Right.
And being born into the church of God. Is that right? And you know, when you look at this, when the angel of God came upon him, it brought fear.
Yes, sir.
You know, the Bible says that Cornelius feared God.
Uh-huh. Yes, sir.
With all his house.
Uh-huh.
He feared God. What do you mean?
Come on,
the Bible says, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandment, for this is the whole duty of man. That's your duty as a child of God, is to fear God and keep his commandment. We're living in times now where men don't feel God no more. Because they're doing whatever they want and whatever they feel like doing it. They don't care about the word of God because they want to do their own thing. And if you're doing your own thing, it means that you don't fear God. You know, the Bible said he was a devout man. From a Jewish standpoint, he was a good man, keeping the laws of Moses, even though he had not been converted outside. But he knew that he loved God.
That's right.
You know? And he kept the principles of the law of the Ten Commandments and all the rest. It mattered to him to be a good person. So he treated people right.
Yes, sir.
And worried about God's opinion of him.
Yes, sir.
His action and his motives. The Bible says that he prayed to God every day.
Mm-hmm.
We know in John 9:31, the Bible said, for we know it, God heareth not us, but those that worship him will be here. Well,
come on,
Cornelius worshiped him, but he was an outsider. But because God had made a promise, get out there 62:1-2. Because God had made a promise to Abraham, somewhere the gate had to be open for the Gentiles to come in. Is that right?
That's right.
You see, it's been Jews all along.
Yes, sir.
The only one that was experiencing the salvation of God was the Jews. For thousands of them had been baptized, but they were only Jews.
Yes, sir.
No Gentiles whatsoever.
That's right.
But in Isaiah 62:1-2, the Bible says,
For thine sake, I will not hold my peace.
God said, I will not hold my peace.
And for Jerusalem's sake,
I will not rest.
Until the righteousness goes forth as brightness.
And salvation.
As the lamp to burn. The Gentiles.
That's you and me.
shall see your righteousness.
That's you and me.
Uh-huh.
The Gentile
shall see your
that's not yet coming to the body of Christ.
That's right. Not yet.
Not yet.
That's it.
Right? Even though Cornelius loved God.
Come on, preacher.
But he was held out because he was yet a Gentile. Uh-huh. But God seeing the righteousness, it's time for this thing to play out, and it's time for the Gentile to come in.
That's right.
The Gentiles shall see your righteousness.
And the Gentiles shall see your righteousness.
And all kings your glory.
And all kings your glory.
You shall be called by a new name.
You shall be called by a new name.
With the mouth of the Lord.
With the mouth of the Lord.
We'll name.
We'll name.
Come on, preacher.
And we all know that in Acts 11:26.
Yes,
right. The Bible says they worked there in Damascus for a whole week, and then out for a whole year.
Uh-huh.
They was first called Christians in Antioch.
Yes, sir.
For a whole year. Now, but yet, this was only prophecy. The Gentiles had yet not been admitted into the Church of Christ.
Come on, friend.
So far, we're dealing with prophecy. Mm-hmm. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
But you know, in verse 5, the Bible says, now sent men to Joppa at the call for one Simon, whose surname is Peter.
Yes, sir.
He's lodging with one Simon, a tanner, whose house is by the seaside, and he shall tell thee what thou shalt do.
That's it.
You know, it's strange how we keep dealing with all these spirits, but ain't none of them telling us how to be saved. They're always recommending somebody else. Is that right?
Right.
And I remember reading that Paul said, for we have this seal in earthen vessels.
Uh-huh.
We are the one. We are the one.
Yes, sir.
You see, God wanted man to obey the gospel from man and not from somebody from somewhere else.
Come on, please.
Is that right? And then the Bible says, and when the angel which spake unto Cornelius was departed, he called two of his household servants and a devout soldier of them that waited on him continually. And when he had declared all these things unto them, he sent men to Joppa.
Yes.
That was only the first rung of the thing.
Uh-huh.
Is that right?
Right?
He sent them unto Joppa. But at the same time, I just want to say that Peter went into a trance.
Come on.
And God let down a gate from out of heaven.
Yes, sir.
Is that right?
That's right. What did he say?
And he had all kind of four-footed beasts.
Yes, sir.
On this land. And Peter, being a Jew, like I told you, they had special diet. They couldn't just eat anything like everybody else.
Right.
It had to be with the kosher.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it had to be kosher.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And when he let it down, pick that up, David, and verse 11.
11?
Yeah.
And saw heaven open.
And heaven opened.
And an object like a great sheet.
And an object like a great sheet.
Bound at the four corners.
Bound at the four corners.
Descended to him.
Extended unto him.
And let down to the earth.
And let down to the earth. Read.
In it.
In it.
Were all kind of four-footed.
Were all kind of four-footed beasts.
Of the earth.
Of the earth.
Wild beasts.
Wild beasts.
Creeping things.
Creeping things.
And birds of the air.
And birds of the air.
And a voice came to him.
And a voice came to him.
Rise, Peter.
Rise, Peter, you princess rascal.
Kill any.
Rise up, you old princess rascal.
Come on, man. All right. What did Peter say?
Kill and eat. What did Peter say?
What Peter said.
Peter said.
Not so, Lord.
Not so, Lord.
But never eaten.
I have never eaten anything
common.
That's common or unclean.
Yes, uh-huh.
I haven't eaten anything unclean.
Uh-huh.
But you see, God had asked for him.
That's right.
Read.
And a voice spoke to him.
Read.
Again the second time.
He spoke to him a second time.
What God has cleansed.
He said, what God has cleansed.
You right. Must not call common.
Yes, sir.
You cannot call it common. If God cleans it,
right.
It's not common.
That's right.
All right.
If God cleans us, we're not common.
Come on.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
There's lots of us in here need cleaning, too.
All right.
You better know it.
All right. Yep.
Yes.
You know, man. This was done 3 times.
It was done 3 times.
And the object was taken up.
And then the object was taken up
into heaven,
heaven again.
All right.
God raised it up after he had warned Peter. You see, he was warning Peter about something Peter didn't even understand.
That's right.
Because he thought he was talking about food.
That's right.
But he wasn't talking about food. He was talking about people.
Uh-huh.
Is that right?
Right.
Four-footed beast. Read on.
Now while Peter wondered within himself.
Now Peter said, I don't know what this means. I don't exactly understand what's going on, but he wondered in himself, why did this happen?
What this vision which he had seen meant.
Read on.
Behold, the men who had been sent from Cornelius.
The men who had been sent from Cornelius
had made inquiries.
And made inquiries
at Simon's house.
At Simon's house.
And stood before the gate. And they called and asked whether Simon. Whose surname was Peter. Was lodging there.
Right. Now, Peter had a problem. First thing, he was a Jew.
Right.
And Jews had no dealing with Gentiles whatsoever.
Right.
He had a problem with these men coming to inquire about him.
Right.
He had a problem. But the Lord told Peter, go with him. Go with these men.
All right.
And when he got to the house of Cornelius, Cornelius fell down at his feet and began to worship him. Peter said, I'm just a man just like you.
Yes, sir.
But he was so anxious to learn what Peter was to teach him.
Yes,
is that right?
Uh-huh.
He had called neighbors, friends, and probably some of his soldiers. He had called them all to his house because he wanted them to hear the word too.
Yes,
that's the way we ought to be.
Right.
We ought to always be inviting somebody to come to hear the word. You know what we're saying? Well, they ain't gonna obey the word. You don't know who obey the word.
That's right.
That's right.
It's time for us to stop judging what other folks do.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Just invite them. And leave it up to God. We don't know how the word of God will prick anybody's heart. We don't know. That's why Jesus told us to go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. You see, because we don't know who will or who won't obey the gospel.
That's
right. Is that right?
That's right.
But read on, this is strange stuff in here.
In verse 34,
Then Peter
opened his mouth and said,
In truth I perceive
that God shows no partiality.
Has what?
Shows no partiality.
Has no respect of persons.
Right. But in every nation.
But in every nation.
Whoever fears him.
years, Jeremy.
And work righteousness.
And work righteousness.
Is accepted by him.
Is accepted by him.
That's it.
You see, Peter tried to let him know now. He learned his lesson.
Mm-hmm.
And now it's left up to God. Go down and teach them according to the word of God.
That's right.
Because Peter was telling them what they ought to know.
That's right.
Right, right.
That's the job of a preacher.
All right.
Come on, preacher.
I'm telling you this, Ellis, because I know that's what you intend to be. The job of a preacher. Leonard, I know that's what you intend to be.
Right.
As a preacher.
Amen.
I know y'all don't think much of us. But we got to tell you the truth anyway.
Amen.
Drop on down to where they were baptized. I mean, where they received the Holy Ghost.
While Peter was still speaking.
While Peter was still preaching the gospel to them.
These were. The Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit.
Fell upon all of those. Who heard the word. And those of the circumcision.
Who believed.
Were astonished.
And because they thought that the word was only for the Jews.
That's right.
But God, I'm going to break this mess up.
That's right.
All right.
Mm-hmm. It's time for everybody to come in here. My son died, the Jews don't obey me. So I'm gonna get some people in here that will obey me.
Yes, right. Right.
Mm-hmm.
And the Bible said, why you just make it the Holy Spirit fell upon all of them.
Yes. That's right, all of them.
You see, it was just like the day of Pentecost.
Mm-hmm.
They had just even been baptized.
That's right.
But they were getting baptized after the Spirit had fallen upon them. Is that right?
Uh-huh.
And so, we as children of God, we need to learn how to be like a niece.
All right.
Learn how to pray always.
All right.
Is that right?
Right.
Uh-huh. Give alms to the people.
That's right.
Help those that can't help themselves.
All right.
Cornelius had a good heart. He was just on the outside.
That's right.
But now Cornelius, after Peter taught him what he should know,
come on,
they were all baptized for the remission of their sin. And if you're sitting here today and you're full of sin, you need to get baptized for the remission of your sin.
Amen.
Is that right? You see, that's the only way God can save any of us. Because Jesus said, if you believe that I'm not me, you will die in your sin.
That's right.
Where I am, you cannot come.
Yes,
sir. That's what Jesus said.
Amen.
I don't know how you feel about the Lord. I don't know how obedient you are to the Lord. But I tell you this, that God, if you can't put him first, you can't put him at all.
That's right.
Because he will not accept any other position. He will not accept any other way. Is that right?
Amen.
That's right.
Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and its righteousness, and whatever you need shall be added unto you.
That's right.
I don't know if you're here tonight and you are not a member, you need to be baptized. If you're here for that reason, we're here to baptize you tonight.
That's right.
Don't put off the day for tomorrow, because nobody knows what's on tomorrow.
That's right.
What is your life but a vapor that appears for a little while, and then it vanishes away?
Yes.
How do you feel about Jesus? Do you love him?
All right.
Mm-hmm. You know, lots of us like to talk that talk, Brother Williams, but we won't walk the walk. You know, this is something that you do when you don't even feel like doing nothing.
That's right.
You still try to show God your very best.
Right.
That's all God wants from us. My best might not be as good as yours, but he wants my best for me.
That's right.
Is that right?
That's right.
So you're here tonight. and you feel like you need to go down in the water to be baptized, because Jesus said he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved.
Yes.
But he that believeth not shall be condemned.
That's right.
Do you want to be condemned or do you want to be saved?
That's right.
That's left up to you. It's not left up to anybody else. It's just left up to you.
That's right.
We're going to give you this opportunity to make your calling and election sure tonight.
That's right.
Whether you want to serve God or whether you want to follow man.
Right.
We're going to give you this chance. Together we stand and sing.
Amen. 95. 595. God.